Football is presented by Geico. Head coach Sonny Dykes trying to fire up his squad as they try to get a victory here at home at Memorial Stadium. A beautiful day. Justin Kutcher alongside James Bates and Brady Papinga. And James, you and I spoke about these offenses. For more on them, let's go down to Brady.
The air raid offense, which is the offense of choice for both Sonny Dykes and Mike Leach, was an offense that was founded on two simple concepts. The first concept is ball distribution. They want to be able to distribute the football equally amongst their skill position players. The second concept is space. They want to utilize space to their advantage offensively. So although this offense may look complicated, when it really comes down to it, it's very simple. When it's ran correctly, it's extremely potent. Justin?
It can also be extremely fun to watch. Cal won the toss, elected to receive. Andrew Fernie will kick off. We're underway here in Berkeley. Treggs takes it at the 10. And Treggs is across the 25, up to the 27-yard line. James, how about the impact players on this side of the ball?
Well, unlike Washington State, Sonny Dykes, his bear raid offense, if you will, wants to run the football. Whether it's Bigelow or Lasco, whoever it is, they have got to get a ground game going and open it up for guys like Grissom. Daryl Monroe and Deion Buchanan are football players through and through. They will make play after play during this game today, just as they have all season long. Monroe been a lot of fun to watch preparing for this one at the linebacker spot.
Jared Goff in the shotgun on first down. The high snap. Goff forced out of the pocket. On the run, throws towards the sideline and completes the pass for 2 yards. Finds Kenny Lawler. Jared Goff, we talked about his week last week. Not what he was hoping for at Oregon, but on the season has put up some impressive numbers.
A true freshman, graduated early, went through spring ball, won a highly contested competition in camp.
First flag of the day is thrown, and it's going to be a false start here against Cal.
Prior to the snap, false start, offense number 78. 5-yard penalty, remains second down.
That's Freddie Tagaloa. Sonny Dykes in his first year here at Cal after spending the last 3 years at Louisiana Tech. You mentioned this in the open. Last year at La Tech, the most potent offense in all of football. Second down and 13. Goff over the middle is complete. Chris Harper for 9 yards.
Yeah, I find it interesting. There's the Pirate, Mike Leach. Mike Leach and Sonny Dykes, you mentioned it off the top, Justin. They go way back to those Kentucky days and coached a lot of good football in Lubbock, Texas with the Red Raiders. There's a big third down and 4 now.
On third and 4, Goff again throws, takes the pass near side, again to Harper for the first down. Up to the 48-yard line, a 14-yard completion.
Find it very interesting. Cal wins the toss. We want the football. Let's get our freshman quarterback feeling right again after the terrible performance where he was pulled with all the fumbles last week. Dry ball and back to the original Goff.
The blitz was coming. The pass completed to Harper again. Chris Harper, one of the favorite targets of Jared Goff. It's Harper and Treggs, the two main targets. A completion of 3 yards on first down. And that's 4 consecutive pass plays, 4 for 4 for Jared Goff. Second down and 7 coming up here for the Golden Bears. The opening drive of the ball game. And we have our first run play. Lasco able to avoid the tackle in the backfield, then gets tackled by Deion Buchanan after he picks up 3.
There wasn't a lot of fight, as you can imagine, in a 55-17 pounding at Oregon last week. But that guy right there, number 2, Daniel Lasco, was a guy who fought every time he was in the football game, and that is huge to see some of the ground game get going. They have to get some ground game going, so Washington State is forced to respect it. Now you're in a third and very manageable, very respectable 4 yards to go again.
Brendan Bigelow now in at tailback on third and 4. Goff, the quick slant, that is complete for the first down to Richard Rogers. The big 6'4", 245-pound junior who lost 35 pounds in the offseason.
Sonny Dykes has worked with the scout team for his defense all week. He said, guys, Leach loves the slants on third and medium. Looks like Sonny likes him too.
How about the one-handed catch by Darius Powell? And Powell has another first down. This time a 17-yard completion.
Great job, and the offense is ticking, and now we're seeing some of these athletes step forward. Great job by Powell to go up and one-hand it and pull it back in.
First and 10 from the 22. A good opening drive here for the Golden Bears. Showing blitz offsides, free play here for Cal, throwing it up, and that is incomplete. Was looking for Drake Whitehurst. Nolan watched it on the coverage.
Good job by the
offside freshman. Defense number 13. 5-yard penalty. Replay first down.
First and five now here for Cal.
At 13, they jumped off as Monroe, as you look at the numbers, not a bad start. Perfect, and 53 yards to go. Here's a nice first and five. But Monroe is a great blitzer, and I can handle a 5-yard penalty every now and then with him being just a little bit too antsy, because he ends up making a lot more plays than he does mistakes.
First and five, Bigelow in the backfield. The handoff is to Bigelow, tries to cut it back. Bigelow with a spin. He's going to be marked down. Looks like just shy of that marker. Picks up four, Daryl Monroe and Cyrus Cohen with the tackle.
And if I need a couple with this offense, I'm going behind Big Jordan Rigsby and Freddy Tagaloa on that left side of the line, 310 and 330, the power side.
Second and one, it's Bigelow again. Bigelow breaks a tackle and gets inside the five, down to the four. First and goal from the four after a 9-yard run. Goff again hands off to Bigelow. Bigelow, this time he's going to lose a couple of yards. Got tackled by Ioane Nauta. A tackle for a loss of two. So second and goal now from the six. And Bigelow goes out. Daniel Lasco comes back in at tailback.
They've established this run, and it's a big stop for that Washington State defense there to finally turn them back. A run that was starting to hurt them a little bit, and you open up this running game and can make this offense really tough to defend all across.
Second and goal from the six, a fumble on the exchange. Lasco couldn't hang on to it, and Washington State recovers. Calafatone Pole with the recovery for the Cougars. And a huge mistake right there for Cal. They were marching down easily at the six, the fumble.
And no excuses here, Justin. It's there, put in the breadbasket by Goff. Lasco didn't secure it. And there's no excuse here. 77 degrees, as good as it gets that weather, much unlike Eugene, Oregon, where they could not hold on to the football to save their lives in the workhorse last week. Not very many with a Bear uniform on puts it on the turf, and so costly. Momentum on the opening drive, all for naught.
Five turnovers last week for Cal, the first one here today on first down. The pass is incomplete from Connor Halliday, looking for Dom Williams. Isaac Lapite was there on the coverage.
Good job by Isaac Lapite to know. Sudden change, they're gonna try to go up top, especially when you got a riverboat gambler over there calling the football plays like Mike Leach. Nice coverage, and it is nice, Washington State fans, to see Connor Halliday start this football game. This is a pretty good quarterback, finally getting healthy and getting some reps and some rhythm.
On second and 10, Halliday comes near side, completes to Gabe Marks, and Marks has the first down. Tackle by Stephen McClure. Time to look at the impact players on this side of the ball.
And right on cue, Mr. Marks. Thank you very much. Dom Williams, Gabe Marks, two sophomores. There'll be a lot of guys that touch the ball for the Cougars. Those two are the ones that can really make big things happen. Stephen McClure, the cornerback, and DeAndre Coleman, very important for Cal. Coleman especially inside to get that push up the middle.
Little shovel pass to Christoph Williams, and Williams will get a yard. Tackle by Jalen Jefferson. So second down and 9 here coming up for Washington State.
Nice job there, Justin, to get up there and set that corner right now by the defensive end. Kyle Cragen. Let his buddies come make a play.
On second down, Halladay. Throws and it's incomplete to Vince Maley. Connor Halladay on the season coming in. You expect him to put up big numbers as he's limping just a bit. And he has put up big numbers, but you'd like to see those interceptions go down.
Well, 3 of those 300-yard passing games this year, 2 4 touchdown games this year. Right now, only number he wants is 1, a first down on 3rd and long.
3rd and 8 here for the Cougars after the fumble. Halladay throws it up, and that one is hauled in. Completed to Gabe Marks right at midfield for a 27-yard completion. Stephen McClure was there on the coverage, but a great catch by Marks. And now a flag has come in on the far side of the field.
After the play, personal foul, defense number 3. 15-yard penalty from the end of the play, automatic first down.
That's against Cameron Jackson, who was questionable for this game with a high ankle sprain.
Boy, how costly is that? And how about the throw from Halladay? Hand fighting McClure and Marks all the way down. It wasn't bad position at all, but so worried about getting the hands off of him, he didn't snap that head around and make a play on the football. Beautifully thrown pass.
On first and 10, incomplete. The pass intended for Brett Bartolone.
Let's go back and take one more look at the third and long. Fighting with the hands the last 10 yards, and there you see the separation, just enough for the sophomore, who was just added, by the way, to the Biletnikoff watch list, and showing you why early here.
Second down at 10, Teandre Caldwell and Marcus Mason both in the backfield here for Washington State. Halladay down the far sideline. That is complete. Touchdown. Vince Maley, and a flag on the play, most likely going to be pass interference. Third and 5 completion to Maley for the touchdown.
Well, Halliday's having a
pass
tough time.
Interference. Defense, number 20. That penalty is declined. Touchdown.
Well, Halladay, the only Cougar not celebrating right now. You see him slam that helmet down. It could be a long day. Let's see if he continues to be able to fight through this pain. Obviously, he has a lot of it.
Andrew Ferney on for the extra point. They recover a fumble at the 6. They go all the way down, convert on 3rd down, and a touchdown pass to Vince Maley. He's excited, but his quarterback, Connor Halladay, he's hobbling just a bit. It's 7-0 Cougars here in the first. The Cougars went 92 yards in 92 seconds. In 7 plays, the 35-yard touchdown pass to Vince Maley, his 3rd touchdown of the season. And now it's Andrew Ferney kicking off again to Bryce Treggs. A couple of very, very good passes by Connor Halladay on that drive. Treggs backs up into the end zone. He'll take a knee, and Cal will start at the 25.
The touchdown, the biggest, Justin, but how about all the big completions on this drive by the junior quarterback? 13-yarder, 27-yarder, and from 35 out, again, just dropping dimes. And again, it wasn't bad coverage. It was a defensive back in Isaac Lapite that was too worried, really, about the hand fighting. We saw it on the other side of the field with McClure and these big, strong wide receivers. Like Maley, that's a 6'3", 240 pounds. It's going to be a long day for a 5'9" corner if they can't hang.
Goff pressured, he goes down. Gets sacked by Cachet Palacio. A loss of 10.
Boy, speaking of a long day, hey, freshman, watch this right defensive end, Palacio, come. Watch him get off the ball, boom. Barely even getting a paw on him, going low. Great technique to stay low, keep those pads away from the lineman's hands.
Second down and 20. Quick pass to Chris Harper. Big chase from behind as he gets up to the 20-yard line. And that brings us to our first Lowe's Never Stopping Proving game break. Here's Patrick O'Neill.
Great play to show you between Rutgers and SMU. Mustang quarterback Garrett Gilbert needing this two-point conversion to force overtime. Looks like he's throwing it away, but no. Jeremy Johnson comes up with it. Third double overtime, 49-42 Rutgers.
Back here in Berkeley, an incomplete pass intended for Kenny Lawler, defended by Nolan Washington. So that brings up fourth down and a punt here for Cal.
Nice job by Mike Bresky's Cougar defense, a defense that's been making all the noise this year up until last weekend.
Cole Leininger now on to punt here for the Golden Bears with Leon Brooks back at his own 35-yard line. And a flag. And it looks like it's going to be false start here.
Prior to the snap, false start. Offense number 10, 5-yard penalty, remains fourth down.
It's one thing on a monsoon type day in Eugene, Oregon, to go out there and sputter around and just let it snowball on you and just play like a complete mess. But if Sonny Dykes is serious and these guys will listen about changing the culture, this isn't the start. It sure looked like it on the opening drive until the fumble. But these penalties, the personal foul especially, it's not the culture of a winning football team right now.
A good punt drives Brooks all the way down, and he gets hit right away at the 30-yard line by Stephen McClure. A 55-yard punt and a flag on the field.
This, how's this for culture? A culture shock, Washington State. This flag, unfortunately, is probably going to be on Cal. But just to light a little bit of a spark, you almost...
After the play, dead ball, personal foul, number 20 of the kicking team. 15-yard penalty will be enforced from the end of the play. Automatic first down.
That's against Isaac Lapice. And that's the second dead ball personal foul of this quarter against Cal. But the hit delivered by Stephen McClure on special teams. Washington State with the ball, leading 7-0 when we come back. 7-0 back here at Memorial Stadium in Berkeley, California. And during the break, the referee, Jack Wood, actually reversed that dead ball personal foul. It wasn't against Cal, it was actually against Washington State, and that is against Deon Buchanan. So it's a 15-yard penalty. That was it. And so it backs this Cougars offense up to the 15-yard line.
They need some push this time, Justin. They need some push from up the middle. Moala and Coleman, you've got to help.
On first down, Halliday back to pass. And that pass is incomplete. The flag comes flying out. Cameron Jackson on the coverage. Dom Williams, the intended receiver. And it looks like this is going to obviously go against Cameron Jackson.
Guys, you can't play with your hands. Every time these Cal defenders have been running with these receivers, they've got their hands all over them.
Number three. 10-yard penalty from the previous spot and an automatic first down.
That's already the fourth penalty against Cal after having 11 last week.
Well, and there's no doubt about this one. Just keep leverage, and Cameron Jackson's too good of an athlete to lose position and fall for that inside move. That's why I tackled him, just to save what could have been an even bigger hitter.
First and 10 now from the 25. Off to T'Andre Caldwell. A helmet comes flying off. Another one comes flying off. It'll be a pickup of 3 yards. A couple of Cal players have to come out as their helmets came off.
Moala, one of them. The other one is Kyrie Fort, who changed from that 11 to 22. So two big players that you'd like to have in there trying to get Washington State off the football field. That, by the way, the first run of the game for Halliday in this offense.
Second and seven. Halliday dumps one over the middle. Completes the pass to Ricky Galvin. And Galvin has a first down. Another penalty flag comes flying in.
We are in Berkeley, after all. We don't need your rules and regulations around here, guys.
After the play, personal foul, offense, number one, 15-yard penalty from the end of the play. Chains will be set after the enforcement of the penalty. It will be first and 10.
That's against Vince Maley, who had the touchdown catch. It's a 17-yard completion for a first down. Back it up 15, so really a net gain of two. First and 10 now from the 30-yard line here for Washington State. Mason in motion, they swing it out to him. Mason gets a block down the sideline. Here goes Marcus Mason. Still in bounds and finally chased out by Michael Lowe. Marked down at the 29, a 41-yard completion.
Well, you use your backs not to hand off to and run the football. You swing it out to them. Maybe getting away with a little bit of a hold there and making them pay down the sidelines, Marcus Mason. And, you know, just when I was about to give some credit to a Cal defense that you didn't see at one time against Oregon, outside the edge, just going and forcing that perimeter, taking on those blocks with some force, you get two guys on the ground and you can't make football plays like that.
On first down, the handoff is to Mason. And Mason will get up to the 25-yard line, picks up four.
Now that's got to be exciting for big 66, Getz and 77 Fullington. Getz went in to start at right guard. Fullington moving over to right tackle, knocking a few guys down on the turf. You don't get to do that very often in this offense.
The Cougars averaging nearly 13 yards per play here in this first quarter. Connor Halliday, play action, takes the shot, that is incomplete. Was looking for Gabe Marks, McClure there on the coverage. And this is not good as McClure is now down on the turf. He is the leader of this defense, the captain. His coaches say he's the warrior for the team.
Gosh, the big question mark was Cameron Jackson coming into this one, as you mentioned, was a game time decision with Lapite starting for him. And here you got your do it all man. He's hurting right now. That hurts.
Stephen McClure down on the fields. Washington State marching down the field, leading 7-0. Stephen McClure being looked at by the training staff of the Cal Golden Bears. Joel Willis comes in for him. Jeremiah Laufusa is now in the backfield. Third down and six for Washington State.
See how they're helping Willis right now.
On third down, it's Laufusa. Laufusa is going to be stopped. A 2-yard run brings up fourth down here for Washington State. And Brady, what are you seeing defensively for Cal?
Well, Cal, their defensive backs, they're playing more with their hands than they are with their feet. And the problem with that is, guys, is when you tend to grab, the natural instinct is your feet stuck. And that's why a lot of these Washington State receivers have been able to get behind these defensive backs for the Cal Bears. Justin?
Fourth and four. They're going for it here. Halliday. Outside, completes the pass to Dom Williams for the first down.
The quick game, the timing, and it's a defense. Sonny Dykes told his defense, look, we're not doing anything different than we do against our offense this week. We should give our best. We should play our best of the year because there will be nothing new to us. That is nothing new, but it's just a great timing being on the same page between Halliday and his receiver for a first.
Halliday, another quick pass, this time complete to Bobby Ratliff, an 8-yard completion.
It's an offense that can chew you up underneath and then hit you with the big ones. We've seen a lot of big passes early in this football game. It's an air raid system that really started Everybody called it more of a dink and dunk game, but it's Leach, when he kind of took it to Oklahoma, he started opening things up a little bit.
Laufassa back in the backfield here for the Cougars. Halliday to the end zone. That is incomplete. Was looking for Vince Maley again. No flag is thrown. Isaac Lapite was there on the coverage.
Well, it may be an officiating crew that just got tired of throwing that flag because Lapite had his paw all over Big Maley on the fade route. Maley couldn't break free to run underneath. A little touch pass by Halliday.
Third and two coming up. They have to get to the six for the first down. The handoff to Mason. Mason trying to get to the outside, but a stiff arm gets run out by Lapite, and it looks like he will have enough for that first down. And now Mason is slow to get up. A timeout as Mason is on the ground in some pain.
Medically, these two teams can't buy a break. Caldwell was injured last week against Stanford. There you see on the edge, defensive end. Little grabby there too by the line, couldn't turn it back. And it's off to the races for the run. It's close up there to the first down stick, but the damage coming with the momentum, not a dirty play, and it's good to see Mason. But it looks like that right arm, he's holding very gingerly.
Well, Mason running off the field. He got the first down, so first and goal is coming up from the five here for Washington State. Leading 7-0, 4:42 to go here in the first quarter. Justin Kutcher alongside James Bates and Brady Papinga. And it's Laufassa in the backfield.
These big old splits by the offensive lineman.
Handoff, Laufassa to the end zone. Touchdown. Jeremiah Laufassa with his fifth rushing touchdown of the year. This one from 5 yards out. And another player is down on the field, this time for Cal. It's Jalen Jefferson. The medical staff ran out right away for Jalen Jefferson. 6'2", 230-pound sophomore from Oxnard, California. He's lying face down on the ground right now. And this is not what you want to see.
You know what happened in the thick of it there, so.
Both teams will leave the field right now as Jalen Jefferson is being tended to by the medical staff of Cal. We hope to have an update when we come back as Washington State leads 13-0.
It's UFC Wednesday on Fox Sports 1.
Stadium, Jalen Jefferson, the linebacker, the player injured for Cal, but seeing him stand up, this is great because he was not moving for a little bit, lying face down. They were able to roll him over and eventually sit him up, and now he'll be helped off the field.
Oh, wow, and it was just as we were coming back from break that they popped him up, so, oh, hallelujah. Jalen, that was a scary moment, and it's not really that ugly of a play. Of course, here he comes in watching, you know, you taught to put that head in front of the ball carrier. Sometimes you just got to do whatever you can, and it, like I said, doesn't look that bad, but, you know, a bad stinger or jamming that neck can really, really, you know, knock you out, black you out a little bit. And let's hope that that's all it is just a jammed neck, if you will. But it wasn't pretty there for a while. Everybody holding their breath, so good to see seven up and at him.
Andrew Fernie now on for the extra point after the touchdown run. And he converts. It's now 14-0 Washington State with 4:21 to go here in this first quarter. Love. Fusa with a touchdown. And it's 14-0 Cougars.
You're watching a Fox Sports presentation. We'll have more right after this.
14-0 Washington State leads Cal here. The question coming in was, would either team have a hangover effect after those losses last week? Washington State certainly does not.
Well, both teams were throttled last week. Washington State looked like they were the ones that were a little bit slow getting into this one. Cal, just like they started the first quarter, ended knocking at the door. They have to punch it in.
On first and goal, the handoff is to Bigelow, and Bigelow is going to be marked down just shy of the goal line. So second and goal from inside the one coming up here for Cal.
Like he might have run into the back of one of his own linemen.
Again, it's Bigelow. Bigelow diving for the end zone. No sign yet. Nope, it's going to be third down. Cyrus Cohen with a tackle.
Boy, that defensive line really, really impressive throughout the season, led by Cooper.
Again, it's Bigelow, some confusion.
Whoa,
loose ball. Another fumble inside the five, recovered by Washington State.
There he is, Xavier Cooper, Justin, just a sophomore. Watching him against Stanford, sometimes you watch a Stanford team, perhaps the best team in the country, and guys look like they don't belong on the field with them. That wasn't the case when you turn on the tape and you watch guys like 96 and on the other end, Pole, 98. Watch him take the blocker on, coming across and just rip that football out. He was going to be stopped shy again to strip it and pull it up a huge goal line stand. The second time in this game now, Justin, that Cal has been inside the five and come up empty.
Calafatone Pole with a second fumble recovery of this game, and that is another monumental mistake here for Cal. On first down, they're gonna get a safety though. Wrapping up Caldwell in the end zone. The defense steps up. DeAndre Coleman.
Boy, and this wasn't even close. 91 right in the middle. You see those bodies trying to move and stretch you down the line. He hits Joe Dahl right in the ear hole, and Dahl in turn goes right back into the lap of his running back. That's some push that we called for by those defensive tackles of Cal, and that's what you need.
A big answer right there by the defense of Cal after the turnover at the goal line. So they get the first 2 points on the board for the Golden Bears. And now Washington State will punt it away. Well, that's an interesting start to the second quarter.
Just a few ticks in, and we've had all kinds of excitement. I guess you should expect that when you've got Sonny Dykes going up against Mike Leach.
But I'll be honest, I was surprised they ran the ball. This Washington State team, which doesn't like to run very often, backed up in their own end zone, and they decide to run.
And even on the drive to end the first quarter on a third down and inches, they threw it way outside to convert. But hey, credit. Well, that's so much fun for a defensive line, a group of linebackers. You spend so much time out there in space trying to run down these little ball carriers, and then you get a chance at a goal line stand and you're successful. Oh, that's what you play football for.
Bolin with a big punt chases Triggs all the way back to the five. And Triggs gets upended. And he's gonna be marked down at the 24-yard line.
Well, let's go back to the safety. 56, well, there's Joe Dahl right here. Okay, everybody's moving like a chorus line. You see them all taking that big step? And you know how to stop that instead of the whole flow? Just penetration. Penetration. You see what they're trying to do to you, and you just go and light something up. And that's exactly what you get out of Coleman. Elliott Bosch is the center. There in the middle, and boy, it's, you know, that's the trouble you get. Washington State, unlike Cal, who wants to eventually get to 50-50 run pass, Washington State makes no bones about it. We want to throw the football every single down if we can. So when you get a fourth and one, a third and one, or you get your back on your own goal line and you just need a yard or two for some padding, it's where it gets interesting.
On first down, Goff stepping up over the middle, completes the pass to Harper. Harper down the sideline, cuts it back, and he is wrestled to the ground inside the 20 by Cyrus Cohen.
Oh my goodness, the pass to get him down there at the end of the first quarter. The trigger was pulled so quickly and even faster right here. Watch the freshman. This is why folks are so excited about the Bear Raid and that freshman quarterback. And how about the windows? Cohen was trailing underneath and he lays it in there on the money.
Tip pass, and that's incomplete off the hands of Lasko. And that could have been the third turnover of the game. DeMonte Horton was right there. He had a hand on it. They had marked Chris Harper down out of bounds at the 26-yard line. It was a 50-yard completion. So now it's second down and 10 from the 26.
So much of this offense is about getting the football out fast. You attack the grass and you get it out fast. That was impressive. Quick on the draw.
Hand off to Lasko. And Lasko gets spun around by Xavier Cooper at the line of scrimmage. Second tackle of the game for Cooper. So now you've got third down and 10 coming up. Trailing 14-2. Off the safety. Trying to add some more points on the board are the Cal Golden Bears. Goff steps into the throw, completes the pass to Darius Poe, and Poe will get the first down. An 11-yard completion, DeMonte Horton with a tackle.
This is going to be interesting because they've got some cushion, and the defensive backs do a good job of knowing where those sticks are. Poe, an even better job of just making up his mind. All he needs is a first down. Sticks his foot in the ground and moves the chains.
And off again to Lasko, and Lasko nowhere to go. Deion Buchanan brings him down for a loss of one.
You see why on these last couple run attempts by Lasko, why the run game for Cal is essentially it becomes tunnel screens. It becomes the screen game, and the receivers become their running backs. They've been able to run inside a few times today, but they haven't been able to outrace everybody to the edge and get it turned.
Third time in the red zone for Cal. The first two were fumbles inside the five. Hand off to Bigelow. And Bigelow is up to the 13-yard line, gets three. Darryl Paolo with the tackle.
You see on that play, Justin, how it's just that big zone step, and you see it as a bunch of trained pigs, as my buddy Tommy Bowden calls it, just those big offensive linemen all stepping in unison. But when somebody penetrates, like we saw at the goal line, it can really make a log jam.
Third and eight. Goff gets pulled down from behind by Ioane Nauta. A big time sack, a loss of five, and now the field goal unit's coming on.
Only bringing three, and yet they get the pressure, and then they've got a guy like Junior Nauta, the senior, who knows how to separate, come off of his block, and make a play. Excellent job by the big JUCO transfer. Guy who lost 20 pounds to get in better shape for this football season shows there.
Vincenzo D'Amato on from 35, and that one is good. So after a fumble at the goal line, Cal gets a safety. Now they punch it in for three. But this Washington State offense went back on the field, leading 14-5. 14-5, 11 minutes to go here in this first half. Justin Kutcher alongside James Bates and Brady Papinga. Our Chevy stack comparison. The big number, the two turnovers by Cal, both inside around the 5-yard line. It could be a very, very different ball game.
Well, you talk however you want to dissect this air raid, bear raid offense. It's all about the football in the game of football. Protect the football and you give yourself a chance.
Ricky Galvin will take it from 1 yard deep in the end zone. He returns it out up to the 20-yard line. Washington State coming back out onto the field. And we've seen Connor Halliday hobbling a bit. Brady, what are you seeing on the field?
I saw Colin Halliday just trying to warm up to go back out on the field. You could see every throw was extremely painful. He was wincing. It was just like he was having needles stuck into his side every time he threw the football. So he is dealing with a lot of pain. It shows his toughness, guys.
You see his numbers today, 8-for-15 with a touchdown. Some big third down conversions as well. On first down, he will throw and complete the pass to Vince Maley. And Maley gets hit right away by Lucas King for a pickup of 4.
Well, you talk about toughness and needles, guys. This is Halliday in his freshman year, came off the bench against Arizona State and threw for about 500 yards and then started the next week, and it was Utah that injured him. He lacerated his liver, missed that the rest of that season, that spring, and had a great spring last year.
De'Andre Caldwell in the backfield on second down and 6. Halliday will throw towards the sideline, complete the pass to Brett Bartoloni. Well, a nice job there by Halliday making something happen. Well, there have been points scored on every one of their drives today.
Yes, they have. Unfortunately, that last time, the 2 points were by De'Andre Coleman with the big stuff and the safety.
Third and 1 here for Washington State. Can Cal come up with a big stop? Halliday, the quick pass, completed for the first down to Bobby Ratliff. Lucas King brings him down, but not before a pickup of 9.
Well, you get that ball out quick and you don't have to worry about that rushing as it is. Plenty of space and time for a Halliday who stepped up, saw something he liked to get it to his big receiver in Ratliff to move the chains. I remember Brady talked about him hobbling around a little bit. It was Apodaca who came in and finished against Stanford, went 15 of 29, just a freshman. But Leach said if he needed him, Halliday could have gone back in.
Halliday airing it out down the sideline. A lot of contact, and there's the flag. Isaac Lapite covering Dom Williams, and there was a ton of contact.
I've never seen so many hands from the receivers and the defensive backs as they run down the field.
Pass interference, defense number 20, 15-yard penalty from the previous spot, automatic first down.
You know, when these two coaches were back at Kentucky with Hal Mumme, people used to say that Kentucky, the Wildcats, they thought of themselves as a well-coached backyard team. We've seen a lot of backyard-type ball when the ball's in the air. Guys just fighting with each other with the hands, and you're going to get called 95% of the time defensively, even if the offensive guy is trying to get some space as well. And there's Lapite guilty again.
Play action. Halliday taking the shot again, and it's incomplete.
Great job.
Gabe Marks, the intended receiver, Adrian Lee on the coverage, and time for a game break. Here's Patrick.
Okay, Justin, thanks. Number 6, Georgia at Tennessee. Good news is Aaron Murray for the Bulldogs to Rantavius Wooten, and Murray is now the all-time leading passer in SEC history. The bad news for Georgia, though, running back Keith Marshall suffered a knee injury, and it does appear serious. Justin and James, back to you.
Not good news there for Georgia.
They've already got Gurley banged up, Justin.
Second down and 10. Halliday, the quick pass. This time, it's complete to Brett Bartoloni. And it's Lucas King again with a tackle.
And before we went to Patrick to check in on Rocky Top, Lee, we finally saw it. A defensive back just kind of running in stride, nope, messing around with the hands. Now those DBs are going to need to step up again on third and medium.
Third and four. Caldwell in the backfield. Halliday's pass is complete. Another first down, and this time it's to Christoph Williams. A 9-yard completion on third and four.
Josh going after the big bodies. Christoph is going to break this one down, and you know, it's about these windows. It's about being able, and that's one thing the Air Commander Tim Couch used to do for both of these coaches is thread the needle, put it in those small windows. Nice timing route there by two Cougars for a first.
On first and 10, play action again. They swing it out to Caldwell. Caldwell. It's wrestled to the ground out of bounds by Kyrie Fort. A 7-yard pickup on first down sets up second down and three. And now Marcus Mason comes in. He'll be in the backfield.
Not going to hand to him too much. You take advantage of him out of the backfield. Mason had a big catch earlier. And this time they swing it to Caldwell for some nice yardage on first.
On second and three, Halliday going up top, incomplete for Gabe Marks. Adrian Lee covering Marks. 7:46 to go here in the second quarter. 14-5 Washington State. Third and three.
Well, that's one thing's for sure. Number 12, he's not going to get any better with that bad wheel today. A tough junior quarterback for Leach. Let's see if they can tough one out for 4 yards to gain a first.
Third and three. Quick pass over the middle. It's picked off. Michael Lowe going the other way, but they're going to say he was down. The knee was down back at the 22-yard line. And a flag is thrown as he does a flip into the end zone.
Andy Boo, the defensive coordinator. His head coach, Sonny Dykes, told their defense all week, this is what we see every day in practice. Let's go out and let's play full speed football. Finally, they don't have to think too much. They can go out and make plays. And this is a nice read by Lowe. It's going to be Cal's football. And you know, those are the kind of things. There's the culture, as you see at the end of it. Sonny Dykes over there talking with
Lowe. Ruling on the field. The runner was down. After the play, unsportsmanlike conduct. Dive into the end zone. Penalty will be enforced from the spot where the ball was declared down. First down, Cal.
It is a turnover. Cal will get the ball. The interception by Michael Lowe.
Did his knee touch? That's what they want to think. Some Boo Birds. They're wanting a touchdown for Coach Boo's defense.
You make the call. Was his knee on the ground? Yes.
No question.
Good call by the officials. And the unfortunate part is the unsportsmanlike conduct with a celebration. There's the knee. Cal ball when we come back. For Cal, intended receiver was Bryce Treggs, but on the sideline, Michael Lowe got spoken to by three different coaches. He made the interception, but then to jump into the end zone with nobody near him, unsportsmanlike conduct, you can't be taking those type of penalties. Goff with plenty of time. Open man wide open is Harper. Harper cuts it back. Touchdown pass from Goff to Harper.
Yeah.
And now Vincenzo D'Amato on for the extra point. Points off of turnovers. They got a safety, a field goal, and now off the interception. The tightrope by Harper stays in, cuts it back. He goes in for seven, and Jared Goff loves it. 14-12. Cal coming back here in the first half. Chris Harper has 168 yards already on the day. That was an 89-yard touchdown catch. Wide open as Jared Goff found him. A new career high for Chris Harper with those 168 yards. He had earlier this year in the first game against Northwestern 148. Ricky Galvin from the goal line. Galvin hits the hole and gets across the 25. Up to the 26-yard line.
Justin, we talk about these quarterbacks hitting their receivers in small windows. Those are easy compared to this, believe it or not. When you see a guy this wide open, miscommunication, there's no safety help up top. At first, I thought somebody fell down. It was Horton down underneath in the flat. Finally, a safety coming over. Taliula missing the tackle. And this is a Washington State defense that had done an exceptional job of not giving up the big play, bending but not breaking, only giving up 3 points that point in the game.
On first down, Halliday over the middle, completes the pass to Bobby Ratliff, and Ratliff will get a first down, picks up 12, but that 89-yard touchdown pass was the second longest in school history, bested by a 90-yarder. So 1 yard shy of a school record.
Well, and already leading the nation, Goff with the 5 completions over 50 yards. Just keep adding to that for the true freshman.
Now has 7 as he has 2 in this game. Shovel pass again to Williams, and Williams got hit at the 40, picks up 2 yards. We showed that coaching tree before. We saw that play a lot by Dana Holgorsen in West Virginia.
That away Kyle Cragen to use those hands and separate a couple times today. We've seen him help so much on that edge, something that seems to be lost at times in college football. He understands ball. He understands where everybody else fits into this scheme.
Second down and 8. They swing it out to Marcus Mason. Has some green. Nice spin move. And he has to dive forward up to the 41 just to get 1. Lucas King, good job containing him.
Well, and repaying, King turns him back in, and it's the hustle play by Krager, who comes from way back to jump in on the tackle. Now can they get off of the football field and ride this momentum?
3rd and 7 coming up. The defense came up big before the safety. Can they get a stop here? Halliday with time, lost one over the middle, incomplete for Bobby Ratliff. Ratliff was open. Halliday was trying that touch pass.
Well, last time on 3rd down, they brought the house. This time they fake it a little bit. And Halliday, he wasn't phased at all. He knew what they were up to. And actually, there was no pressure up the middle, so he had space. He's just off the mark. Would love to have that one back. That'll hurt your feelings, not just your ankle.
Mike Bolin on to punts. Chris Harper is back at his own 20. Harper a chance to return. And Harper, good tackle there on special teams. He goes down at the 23, tackled by Jared Byers. A 40-yard punt. We've got a good one here in Berkeley. Back and forth we go as the Cal Golden Bears have scored 12 unanswered, a trail by 2. 14-12, Cal coming back in this one with 5:20 to go in the first half. Justin Kutcher alongside James Bates and Brady Papinga. And Cal will start with the ball at the 23-yard line. Jeffrey Copprich in the backfield here for Cal. On first down, the handoff is to Copprich. And Copprich, with some nice moves, gets up to the 31 to pick up 7. Kupprich had 51 yards on 14 carries last week at Oregon. Kind of got himself into the rotation here.
Absolutely, just a redshirt freshman.
The pass swung out again, this time to Darius Powell for the first down, tackled by Tanah Pritchard. James, we saw Jared Goff kind of get into a rhythm the last couple of drives. Of course, last one, not hard when it's an 89-yard touchdown pass, but he does seem to have that confidence again.
Oh, he certainly does. And you know what was interesting? He entered the football game with it after being about as low as you can. After
Goff pressured, and he goes down. Sacked by Ioane Nauta. He didn't see that one coming. Second sack of the game for Nauta.
Nauta's done a fantastic job. Here you're going to see him just untouched. I mean, I guess it's not hard to just run straight five steps and hit somebody in the shoulder pads. There's the senior. Talked about him losing all that weight, and he looks great running. Still 285.
Second and 18. Goff got hit as he threw wide open, and this is intercepted by Deion Buchanan. Buchanan on the return. Buchanan across midfield. Down the sideline of Buchanan, gets taken out of bounds inside the 20, maybe marked out the 26 by Richard Rogers. And that was Goff just throwing it up. A 48-yard return. And that is the 13th career interception for Deion Buchanan in the fourth straight week with an interception.
Well, they got to him, rocked him the play before. Palacio getting to him this time, just enough pressure, and the freshman can't just hunk it up anybody's ball. At the very least, take the sack and live to play another down. Instead, after the great return, it's Washington State's turn to try to add to this lead.
Third turnover of the game here for California. Halliday, the pass incomplete, looking for Teandre Caldwell.
Seen a couple times Halliday's done a good job of putting it out there for Caldwell and Mason, catching them in stride so they don't have to adjust the body. That time he's way off the mark, and there you see the turnovers that have just plagued these two teams this year.
Utah, six of those 10 turnovers came Thursday night on interceptions by Travis Wilson against UCLA. Halliday over the middle to Bobby Ratliff, and Ratliff gets tackled around the ankles by Joel Willis. A 4-yard completion, and third down and six coming up. You see what Connor Halliday has done with this Cougar offense. They started off great. Since then, a couple of punts, a safety, and an interception. Caldwell in the backfield here on third and six.
Gotta think this is absolutely two down territory.
Halliday with time, throws incomplete, was looking for Marks. Marks cut in. It looked like Halliday thought he was gonna go with the fade. Decision time now for Mike Leach, facing fourth and sixth from the 22-yard line. And he's gonna bring on his field goal kicker, Andrew Fernie. It's going to be a 39-yard field goal attempt here for Fernie to try to put his team up by five. And Fernie's kick is no good. So Cal's defense comes up with a big stop off the turnover.
Looked like somebody got a hand on it, Justin, getting through. Fernie, second team all Pac-12 last year, went 14 of 20, and he hit the long ball here. A nice, easy chipper for him, it seems to be. And it looks like somebody in a Cal uni might have gotten just enough of it to send it wide.
Fernie upset with himself. A big break here for Cal, now 3:11 to go in this first half, and a chance to come back again. On first down, the handoff to Kupprich. Kupprich, good second effort. Up to the 27-yard line, gets five, sets up second down and five.
There you see the footing as he slides with that plant foot. And there's your problem. Nobody got a piece of it, and that's why Fernie's so upset with himself as he walks off.
Again, it's Koprich. Koprich up to the 29, tackled by Palacio.
And Cal trying to keep him guessing here with back-to-back run plays. And some good yardage on both to set up a nice third down and two, but you got to move it.
Everybody looks back to the sideline, changing up the play. Goff with some time, throws over the middle, complete to Harper for a first down. Up to the 35, a 5-yard completion. Justin Sagote with the tackle. And now let's see how Jared Goff can run this 2-minute offense. Harper, 8 catches, 173 yards. Play action, Goff. And that pass is incomplete, was looking for Triggs. Coming up on the Pizza at Halftime Report with Rob Stone, Coy Wire, and Petros Papadakis, they will get you caught up on everything going on around the country. Dominant quarterbacks, Jameis Winston has to be mentioned in that. Teddy Bridgewater, Clemson visits Syracuse. And did we have the play of the year?
The one of all ones, Capital One.
Second down and 10, you'll have to stay tuned to find out. Play clock is down to 4. Goff, that one was hit at the line by Nauta. Nauta's been everywhere for Washington State. 3 tackles for a loss, 2 sacks.
And I'm showing you right there, Justin, this is a well-coached defensive line. Joe Salavea is the defensive line coach. Not going to make it there. Little mirror technique, put those hands up and try to get a piece of it, knock it down and create a third down and 10 and a chance to get the ball back in your offense's hands.
On third and 10, Goff again taking the chance, and that one is incomplete. Chris Harper got a hand on it. Deion Buchanan came over and knocked it away.
Oh, Deion Buchanan, it looks like he hesitated coming out of his break, and that's one thing we're finding out in a hurry. Great job to rake the ball away and then secure the tackle in case you don't get the pigskin. But again, Goff with the quick release and dropping it in there. Washington State lucky there.
Leininger punting it to Leon Brooks, taking it at the 26. Brooks, he gets wrapped up at around the 32-yard line. A 39-yard punt, a 5-yard return. 1:26 to go here in this first half. And it was Washington State getting on the board early after a fumble inside the red zone by Cal. A touchdown pass to Vince Maley. A safety. That put Cal on the board for the first time, and then this was the big play, the 89-yard touchdown catch. Chris Harper, second longest play in school history, 14-12, with 1:26 to go here in the first half. Connor Halliday throws incomplete, was looking for Gabe Marks. It's amazing, you look at the pass versus the run, and James, we had talked about this. We kind of knew it coming in, but Washington State, 14 rushing yards. Cal, 11.
Well, that's, you know, there are different ways to get to this. You hear about the tempo and the spread. You go up to Oregon. It's a team that likes to establish it all through the run, but there are some like Washington State throwing it.
Halliday able to swing it out to Marcus Mason. Mason, good run after the catch. Now has a lot of green with some blockers. Mason, will he be caught? Mason gets pushed to the end zone. Touchdown. 68 yards.
Marcus Mason made that happen with the cutback, then had the blockers, and he did the rest.
One of those blockers, big Vince Maley. No block, no rock. Scored a touchdown earlier, and you got to help your guys out and make those big plays happen.
They're going to review this play to see if he was inbounds reaching for the end zone. It would be a 68-yard touchdown pass to Marcus Mason.
Well, they're going to check it at the end, and if I'm a Cal fan, it's not so much the end that I'm worried about. It's the beginning. That's a simple little swing pass at the most. Should be dropped for an 8-yard gain. Here's a look back at the end of it. Ooh. It's that foot that's going to be in question, of course, the outside foot. That's our best look, and it looks like there is a little bit of green in between, doesn't it?
I couldn't tell from that angle. Let's look at this one.
Yep. Touchdown.
After review, the ruling on the field is confirmed. Touchdown.
But you, Cal, you fought so hard to get back into this football game, being down immediately 14-0. And big plays, you see them across college football. Sometimes you wonder where all the tackling's gone, as Coach Sonny Dykes and his defensive coordinator, Andy Boo, talk it over. Just simple angles. Pursuit, not letting a guy cut back all across the green and go out the gate for a touchdown.
Fernie's extra point is good. Marcus Mason, 68-yard touchdown catch. He had a 41-yard catch earlier. He now has 109 yards through the air here today.
So he comes back, all these bodies. Watch all these guys that overrun. Yeah, he's got a good block on the perimeter. But 1, 2, 3, 4, and then there's the good blocking down the field just off the right of your screen by Maley. And the convoy leading the show. But as you look from the high end zone, bird's eye view, can we pause it right here? Right there, guys. This is outside is going on. You see him, he's going to be forced back. This is what you want to do because all the bodies are coming from inside. Take the proper angles and drop them. There's 1, 2, 3, 4. Four guys that overrun. And that just absolutely cannot happen. And that's not just a tackling thing. That's just a pursuit drill, defensive drill that you do every single day in practice. And that's just letting your guard down and flat out being lazy with a minute to go and costing your football team dearly.
So now it's Fernie to kick off. 1:04 left here in this first half. It's taken at the 7-yard line by Brendan Bigelow. And Bigelow gets back up to the 24-yard line. Don't forget the pizza at halftime reports coming up with Rob Stone, Coy Wire, and Petros Papadakis at the conclusion of this first half. You've got your full allotment of timeouts if you're Cal. 58 seconds to go. And they'll start with the ball at their 25-yard line.
Plenty of time for a get him up type of offense. And Jared Goff has got the arm to sling it, so it could get interesting here before half.
Goff trying to get to Bigelow. That's incomplete.
It's fun to watch some great big athletes on long defensive lines. We've seen plenty of them. There he is, big 98, Pole. To recognize the screen is one thing, being a smart football player. But to have the ability at 300 pounds to turn and go get it and get yourself in the picture, it's fun to watch.
Pressure coming. Goff trying to escape. Goff throws it. He's falling down and completes the pass to Steven Anderson. Xavier Cooper applying the pressure. How Goff got that off, I don't know.
I don't know that Goff is really 200 pounds. They have him listed at 205, but he looks like he's a big 300-pounder fighting off the defensive end there. How about the guts of the freshman quarterback to keep it alive?
Goff with the pressure coming again, able to escape. Throw into the sideline, completes the pass. Again to Richard Rodgers. Marked down at the 26, the pressure applied by Palacio.
What did I tell you they called it back at Kentucky? Well-coached backyard football. That's what it's looked like the last couple plays. A quarterback back there just extending plays, making it happen like a Johnny Manziel type. Oh, by the way, here's a freshman, a true freshman at that in Goff, making things happen with his legs and then arm.
Goff towards the sideline. Is he in? No, incomplete to Bryce Treggs. Stops the clock at 31. He could not get a foot down.
And what a shame. What a beautifully thrown football. Looked like he tried to get that right toe. Every play being looked at, but I may want another peek or two. That's a
second down and 10. Lasko in the backfield. Goff looks over to the sideline. How about this for the first half? 345 yards passing for the freshman Jared Goff. Incomplete to Darius Powell.
Incomplete pass, so it doesn't really factor in, but Sagote that time is an example of what I was trying to coach up last time with Cal on defense. Just a proper angle, coming under control. He's going to make the tackle for a couple yards. And a couple yards thrown through the air by the freshman Jared Goff today, huh, Justin?
Yeah. And now a timeout taken here by Cal.
This will be a 30-second.
Their first timeout with third and 10 coming up. Marching down the field, trying to get some points on the board before this half comes to a close. And next Saturday, the American League's best teams will look to their brightest stars to make the next unforgettable play that will lead them to the ALCS and move them one step closer to the World Series. Legends are born in October, and our coverage of baseball's postseason begins next Saturday at 7:30 p.m. Eastern with game one of the ALCS only on Fox. Every year, love listening to Joe Buck and Tim McCarver, and of course, this being Tim McCarver's last year, will be extra special tuning in for that.
Well, a couple guys I know and stories you've told that have been extra special in your career, and you're a lucky guy to have hung out with those guys coming up as a young pup.
No doubt. Third down and 10 here for Cal. Goff forced out of the pocket, sets his feet, throws. This one just throwing it wide open. And that's the second time we've seen Goff do that, where he just tries to extend a plane and throws one up in the air, up for grabs essentially. And that's going to bring on the field goal kicker, Vincenzo D'Amato.
Getting that pressure coming from the edge. And you know what that says? It's come from the edge a lot. Adcock being out, Mark Brzezinski starting for him at center, has done an exceptional job of filling in for his injured teammate at the center spot.
A 43-yard field goal attempt, and that is absolutely drilled. Vincenzo D'Amato hit from 35 earlier, now hits from 43. And who would have thought? Well, I guess if you're looking at these two teams, most people would have. With about 2 minutes to go, both teams get some points on the board.
Well, and fast and furious. And how about the way Cal's gone about it? They get their first points on the board with the safety, and it was a defense that sparked the offense to finally get some life into them. Some big plays on offense and some big plays defensively. And this is one thing here as we watch these last 15 seconds, one thing that I haven't had a chance to point out, but I've been really impressed with both teams, is the way they've covered these kicks. And we've seen a couple big plays go for both teams. You got to make sure you continue to stay in those lanes and cover here on this one and not give up a big play and a chance at one last big hitter.
15 seconds to go. D'Amato will kick off. Ricky Galvin and Christoph Williams are back deep here for Washington State, leading by 6. Squib kick kept low. Tough time handling it, but covered up now at the 26-yard line by Zach Brevik. Again, coming up in just a couple of seconds, the Pizza at Halftime Report with Rob Coy and Petros. Guys, sorry to keep you waiting. We just have scoring too quickly here.
Having too much fun in the sun, a beautiful day. What a beautiful venue, Memorial Stadium. Got, from what I hear, Brady might be heading up to Tightwad Hill.
Yeah.
At halftime.
Oh, yeah.
Look out.
They've got the chair set up for him up there already.
He needs to find a group like that at every stadium.
10 seconds to go. The handoff to Marcus Mason. And Mason takes this one 5 yards. And that will end the first half. 652 yards of total offense. I said before we could have 1,200 yards of total offense, and I wasn't lying. We're at 652 right now. It's a 21-15 ball game.
There is a place on the...
Fox College Football is presented by Geico. Back here at Memorial Stadium, getting set for the third quarter. Washington State leading Cal by the score of 21-15. Justin Kutcher alongside James Bates, and James, 592 yards of offense. There could have been even more scoring in that first half.
Oh, there certainly could have been opportunities. Opportunities, Cal, when you get down knocking on the door twice inside the five, only one of three in the red zone, they've got to take advantage of those chances. Not just big opportunities, but small ones. An opportunity to make a tackle, drop a guy for an 8-yard gain. Instead, way too many big plays by both defenses given up.
All right, we're set to go here in this second half. Cal will kick off. It'll be Vincenzo D'Amato kicking off. Christoph Williams and Ricky Galvin back deep for the Cougars. Both teams scoring late in that first half. A touchdown for Washington State. A field goal for Cal. About 5 yards deep in the end zone, Galvin will take a knee, and here come the Cougars. How about the offense from Washington State in that first half?
Well, they don't run it much, but they use those backs to flare them out. And here, of course, is Mason after he had one big reception. Now they get him to the edge and watch the blocking outside. Bartoloni inside. And then on the outside, Maley, who's done his damage through the air and blocking with those big paws as well. And then it's a race to the end zone. There's a 41-yarder and a 68-yarder there in the first half. Again, the big plays, 6 20-plus-yard completions in this football game combined, and four of them, Justin, have for Washington State, and Halliday continues to keep that ankle loose. That's one thing. You get to halftime, and that ankle gets cold on you again. You got to lather it up.
There is a player down right now for Cal following that kickoff. We've already seen a couple of guys go out. Stephen McClure went down. Jalen Jefferson went down. Jefferson is not going to return. We were told that during halftime.
It's been a team for Cal, Justin, that they lost their starting center, Chris Adcock, this week. And there's Jalen. Good to see him sitting up and smiling. That was scary earlier.
We'll be back after this. The injured player is Joel Willis, who came in for Stephen McClure. You see Willis having a lot of difficulty trying to get off the field right now. Not what you want to see again. Cal is having some bad luck with injuries. McClure is out. Willis came in for McClure. Adrian Lee is now going to be playing more significant time for Cal. They lost Jalen Jefferson earlier in this game. And it looked like Joel Willis was about to get off the field. And you just saw him as we did. They had to put him back down. He could not get off the field.
When you talk about Jalen Jefferson, Cameron Jackson, remember, he's not at full speed, was injured against Oregon. There's a look at Lee taking a knee, and you better get some rest while you can, young man, because it's these perimeter players. That's three now. They've lost for the game on the edge and against a team like Washington State. You need a lot of bodies and a lot of fresh bodies that can step up and play in the open space. But
Cameron Jackson, his helmet has been off. He had the high ankle sprain. He was questionable for this game. Then he had a couple of penalties. And now they're going to bring out the cart with a stretcher to try to help get Joel Willis off the field.
Willis had fought so hard to get on the field. He was a wide receiver in the 2-a-day camp. His training staff, Sarah Edwards there, one of the orthopedic surgeons here on this team. They've been so busy all the way back to camp.
We're going to come back and update you on the situation, but again, Joel Willis, the player injured, being helped off the field. They're going to put him on a cart and get him back and check him out.
You're watching a Fox Sports presentation. We'll have more right after this.
21-15 back here at Memorial Stadium. Washington State leading Cal. Justin Kutcher alongside James Bates, a captain of the 1996 National Championship Florida Gators, and Brady Papinga, 8-year NFL vet. Connor Halliday in the shotgun here on first down. Halliday throwing towards the sideline, completes the pass to Gabe Marks. A 7-yard completion for Marks.
One thing that I've been really impressed with Connor Halliday, guys, is his ability to get rid of the ball quickly. And I know James has been touching on it with Goff, but as soon as his back foot hits, that ball is out of there. And that's why this offense, talking about the Washington State's passing offense, is being as efficient and effective as they are. And that's because the quarterback is getting rid of the ball on time.
On second down and 3, hand off to Mason up the middle, and Mason will be able to move the chains. Picks up the first down with a 4-yard run. Hey guys, as linebackers, how difficult is it to play against an offense like this?
It's one of the most difficult offenses you could imagine because, like I mentioned, the ball getting out so quick really minimizes the effect of a blitz, because the blitz they just don't get there in time. The ball's already out, so it sort of frustrates you as a linebacker because you don't get a blitz as much.
So you're saying you like to blitz. That's what I'm gathering here.
Amen.
First and 10 here for the Cougars. Play clock is down to 3. Halliday throws it up, and that's incomplete. Isaiah Myers, the intended receiver. Cameron Walker came over, delivered the hit.
Boy, Halliday sure liked what he saw out here, and he lofts it up there, and a good safety help coming over the top by Walker to make sure it was dislodged.
Walker did a nice job with his eyes reading Halliday and having a nice break on the ball to get there to disrupt the catch.
Second down and 10. Halliday's quick pass comes near side, completes it to Ricky Galvin. Cameron Walker there to bring him down. A 9-yard completion. And now third down and 1 coming up. They had a third down and 1 on the opening drive. Then it all of a sudden became a third and 11 and a third and 26. Marcus Mason in the backfield. That quick pass on the slant. And that's textbook for what Mike Leach likes to do on those third and short, third and mediums.
Absolutely, Justin. And Brady, we sat there yesterday, and what did they tell us? Sonny Dykes said third and short, third and medium. Leach loves the slants. Linebackers coming from inside, reading those eyes. You know, it doesn't even take a read right there. Just knowing, having a feel for what that gentleman likes to call up there and make a break on it and disrupt it. And that's a big chain mover for the offense.
Mason on the handoff. And Mason gets up to the 49-yard line, gets 3. Hardy Nickerson with a tackle.
And back to that previous play, guys, everybody that knows Mike Leach's offense knew the slant was coming, but they couldn't stop it. And that's the beauty of that air raid offense, is its simplicity, but at the same time, its effectiveness when you execute it correctly, like they just did there to convert on that third one.
Connor Halliday over 300 yards at 320 on the day. Halliday, the quick pass again to the far sideline of River Craycraft. And Craycraft will come up about a yard shy of the first down.
Speaking of a beauty, guys, Brady, as you were talking about that play, we're seeing the highlight of a young Hardy Nickerson. yes, that Hardy Nickerson, his son, and well, his dad was an excellent football player, big playmaker. And looks like the young man is going to follow in father's footsteps. He certainly did on a school of choice.
One thing I remember about Hardy Nickerson is longevity, 15-year NFL career.
Halliday airing it out, flag on the play, going up, and that is incomplete. Vince Maley had it in his hands, and then Cameron Walker came over, and it looked like he almost took it out of his hands.
Offside, defense, number 55. 5-yard penalty results in a first down.
Viliami Moala called for the offsides penalty. That's the 7th penalty of the game against Cal. And that results in a first down here for Washington State.
Gosh, he lined up offside. You see him up top there. So it wasn't even on a move. Now, how about the safety, Walker, at the end of that play? They just moved him to safety. Two big plays here on this drive. So here's a guy that's growing up in a new position, and he understands, hey, if I'm not going to go make a play myself on that football, rake those wrists and come in there violently to knock it away. And we've seen it two times on this drive.
Second down and 10 coming up here for Washington State. Fade complete to Isaiah Myers. Myers still on his feet as he dives across the 10-yard line. Isaac Lapidze with a missed tackle, and it's a 30-yard completion.
And you know what Myers did really nicely there, guys, is he bended the route enough to where he blocked off the defensive back, and that's really how those routes are made to be. They're made to be bent and manipulated according to how the receivers are being covered.
He also shed that tackle by Lapidze quite nicely. Caldwell on the handoff, cuts it back. Caldwell, touchdown. Teandre Caldwell with his first touchdown of the season. The LA native.
Again, beating him with alignment. We saw it at the other end in the first half. Lau Fassa, the other running back to score. They just spread you out, and it's just too easy when you get your blocks.
Fernie's extra point is good. A 13-point lead for the Cougars. Isaiah Myers, 185 pounds, just throws Isaac Lapidze to the ground, goes for 30. And then Teandre Caldwell. We don't see this very often from Washington State. A running touchdown, 28-15 Cougars. Visit ADT.com/sports to enter for a chance to win an ADT security and home automation system. 28-15 after that 10-play, 79-yard scoring drive that resulted in a touchdown run by Teandre Caldwell. His first career touchdown. Andrew Fernie will kick off. Brendan Bigelow is back deep. Bigelow from the one. Bigelow across the 25 as he got hit up to the 28-yard line.
Well, here's the touchdown, and we go to the big splits to start with, and look at the bodies. There's Bosch, there's Getz. You're going to see coming in off the edge, Ratliff. And that's one thing that Leach did, guys, when he went to Texas Tech, he made the splits bigger. That wasn't one thing that Mummy did at Kentucky, but at OU, and especially at Texas Tech, those big wide splits, and that's showing you why. And that's showing you why one side's happy. And of course, it was that young man, Lapidze, getting to talking to after he gave up the big 30-yarder to set it up.
A handoff to Lasco up the middle, and on first down, Lasco gets tackled by Justin Sagote after picking up 9, so second down and 1. On
the tackle for the Cougars. The linebackers there froze because Goff was given that fake flare pass throw out there. They're thinking it was a throw, and it was actually a run.
This time it is a throw. That's thrown to Harper. Harper, a couple of nice moves to get some extra yards. DeMonte Horton with a tackle. The missed tackle by Cyrus Cohen, a 10-yard completion.
Well, and Brady, last week we had an Army team where you better be ready for run, 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 and oh yeah, we pass it, play action. And it's just the opposite if you're trying to go up against this Mike Leach Washington State offense.
First down, the handoff to Bigelow up the middle, and Bigelow, a good open field tackle there by Deion Buchanan. But not before Bigelow gets 11 for another first down.
Jordan Rigsby, he was the leader on that particular block. These offenses don't have fullbacks, but they have guards who can block like fullbacks.
Goff, another quick pass to Harper. And with that completion, Chris Harper is now over 200 yards today. He is at 202 yards on the day on 11 catches. Not a bad day. Second down and 6. Goff. Little pitch to Bigelow. Bigelow. And there's a flag thrown in the direction of Richard Rogers.
This is probably going to be a hold, and it's a shame because that's exactly what you're trying to do. You got one-on-one, hoping your back can win his little individual battle.
Holding, offense, number 11. 10-yard penalty for the spot of the foul. Replay, second down.
That's going to go against Richard Rogers on the exterior. So it's about to give him credit. And there you see just the arms wrapped around and the fact. Well, my goodness, you got a couple guys battling, and Cohen and Rogers, but he seemed to have that hand on the back of his shoulder pads. And anytime you get a guy wrestled to the ground, when you're out in the open like that, they're going to bring it back. But a good job on the edge to chop down the defensive end to start it, but all for naught.
Second down and 10. Bigelow on the carry makes one miss. Bigelow then got hit hard by Buchanan. Well, with that hard hit, we'll take a break and throw it over to Patrick for a game break.
Okay, guys, yeah, quickly, Oklahoma State coming off that loss to West Virginia versus Kansas State. Big play, J.W. Walsh to Charlie Moore. It makes it 30-29. Cowboys have the ball. They're looking to put this one away. Back to you.
All right, it's Bigelow again on the carry. Again, it's Buchanan with the tackle, a one-yard run. And so now fourth down and one is coming up. Daniel Lasco in the backfield. The Cougars were showing blitz. Goff checks back to the line. Play action. Goff, that pass is deflected, incomplete. It's Nauta who gets a hand on it again and a change on downs.
Yo, Ane Nauta. It was so tough for his teachers to pronounce in elementary school. He said, call me Junior. How about Junior growing up?
Sunday mornings with Fox NFL Kickoff as the guys get you up to speed on all that's happening around the league. Then turn over to Fox to catch America's number one pregame show, Fox NFL Sunday, and hear from Colts quarterback Andrew Luck and head coach Chuck Pagano on Indianapolis' hot start in their showdown with the undefeated Seahawks. It all starts tomorrow beginning at 11 a.m. Eastern,
start,
only on Fox
offense,
Sports 1.
Number 63, 5-yard penalty, remains first down.
So now it's first and 15 here for Washington State. Gunnar Eklund called for the false start.
Well, they just recently called for that hold on the edge on Krager. Try to ride that momentum. You get a fourth down stop. You don't want to back it up 5 yards. You want to put the pedal to the metal.
Connor Halliday wide open, completes the pass to Maley, and Maley breaks free. Maley, touchdown. Yards, second touchdown of the day for Vince Maley. And with that completion, Halliday is over 400 yards now to 428. The extra point by Fernie is good. 35-15, Washington State now leading Cal.
Last series, we bragged on Cameron Walker, the job he did using his hands from that safety position. Here, it's the only thing he doesn't use. Bounces off of him like a ping pong ball. And Vince Maley at 6'3", 240 pounds. Yes, by the way, he's 240 pounds. And look at him run in open field. You better bring everything you have. Makes a decent break. Yes, it's going to be a first down there in that window. But wrap up, give yourself a chance. Big plays, so costly for both of these defenses. And right now, Washington State quieting down this Memorial Stadium crowd with another big hit.
111 yards receiving for Maley in this game. 200-yard receivers for Washington State. Marcus Mason, the other one. Vince Maley, if you didn't know him before, now you do.
Remind everybody, Connor Halliday left the Stanford game in the third quarter, did not return. Apodaca, the freshman, finished up that game. He has hobbled throughout this game. The tough quarterback sticking it in there. And that offense is clicking right now.
4:24 to go here in the third quarter, but coming up 8 p.m. Eastern time on Fox Sports 1, West Virginia against Baylor. Look at what Art Briles, Baylor Bears, have done so far this year, averaging nearly 70 points per game through three games.
And stopping offenses as well. Art Briles has playing some defense, those Baylor Bears. And of course, Briles and Holgorsen, part of this air raid tree.
Shovel pass to Harper. Harper will cut it back, change directions, get some blocks. Goff gives him a block. And Harper across the 40, up to the 41. It will be a first down here for Chris Harper.
Getting creative on the ground, that's what you got to do, and get the ball in the playmaker's hands, whether it's little quick screens or the pitch like that.
Hand off to Lasko. Lasko breaks free. And he gets up to the 48 of Washington State.
Well, a winner at quarterback with a quick release will fire up a team, but a block like that down at the bottom of your screen to go low and take out the defensive lineman, Nauta, really get this team behind him.
You can see the arm strength of Goff as he throws that ball without setting his feet, going away from where he's trying to throw, and he almost completes it.
Ineligible downfield, offense, number 78, 5-yard penalty, replay first down.
That's against Freddie Tagaloa.
Well, you get 3 yards of cushion. This is the Cal team. They like to get down the field. Of course, on a screen pass behind the line of scrimmage, you can do that. Rarely is it called.
Goff, airing it out, he completes the pass to James Grissom, and Grissom goes in for the touchdown. A 53-yard touchdown pass to James Grissom, another play over 50 yards.
Right back at you. Grissom had a 61-yarder against the Buckeyes a couple weeks ago.
D'Amato with the extra point, 35-22. And now that's 8 passes of 50 or more yards on the season for Jared Goff.
Well, and it's DeMonte Horton on the coverage. And Horton, rather than just kind of put that head down when he's got a couple steps on you, and go and make yourself part of it. He takes a peek, and there's just too much space. You see the separation? You're not peeking unless you can feel that body. You do all you can to keep contact with that receiver, because when there's a gap, when there's space, that's where you get in trouble and making him pay. It's big James Grissom with the big play.
You hear a lot of talk now in football, both college and the NFL, that 400 is the new 300, where it used to be a big deal to have 300 passing yards. Now 400 is the big, I guess, the big deal. Well, both these guys have over 400 passing yards. Halliday 428, Goff with 438, and we still have 333 to go here in the third quarter.
We're just getting started. Our crew tonight, they've got a team in Baylor that had 70 early in the third quarter just a couple weeks ago. Plenty of offense for you today on the network.
Galvin will take a knee in the end zone, and Washington State will start at the 25-yard line. Connor Halliday last year was pulled against Cal, and he's wanted redemption, and he's getting it right now. 28 of 44 for 428 yards.
Now, the one interception today, when he was reading these, when he turned the ball over a couple times, said Elliott sweats a lot. That's his center, big sweaty center.
And now he tries to step up and gets crunched by Puka Lopa. It's one of the best names in college football. Puka Lopa.
Puka Lopa. You know, so sounds pretty good right now for Cal fans. And can they do it back to back? Don't give up the big play. You got them going the right direction. If you're on defense, keep them in front of you. No big plays now. Work your way back into this football game trailing by 13 points.
On second down, it's a handoff to Caldwell. And Caldwell will get three, so third and long coming up. If you're Cal, you need to get the stop right now. You cannot afford to let Washington State convert here on third and 12, back in their own 23-yard line.
And remember that one interception that they forced Halliday into? They brought the house. Let's see if they dial up another pressure package.
Halliday's pass towards the side is complete. Bobby Ratliff, enough for the first down.
Justin, Isaac Lapite is having a rough second half. Mike Leach sees it, and they are just going to continue to work that left side of the field. We've had McClure go down.
Joe Willis go down.
Willis went down. And they're picking on that corner right now, and it's working.
Halliday, long pass across the field, looking for Brett Bartoloni. And that's incomplete. 1:58 to go here in the third. How demoralizing is it as a defender to give up a first down like that?
Especially when you're gassed, when you've been chasing these offenses up and down the field all day long, and you've got them where you want them. It's not like a third down and three and, oh gosh, they got us. You've got them right where you want them. It's just a punch to the gut when they convert and move those chains on a third and forever.
Second and 10. Halliday gets it off to Mason. Mason slips a tackle in the backfield. Lucas King could not wrap him up in the backfield. And instead of a loss of a few yards, it's a pickup of four.
King filling in for the injured Jalen Jefferson, and he's really been solid today. And a great break on the ball, good position even. But again, wrapping up. We saw it the last time down from the safety, Walker. Got to bring those hands and those hips as well. Bring everything you got to drop these ball carriers.
Third and six. Do you look for a slant or a fade?
I bring everybody. Put some pressure on Halliday again.
They're bringing some pressure. A good block in the pass. It is complete to Ricky Galvin.
Justin Halliday's hurt. He does such a good job to extend. Here the blitz, the pressure's going to come from right here on the right side. Lucas King is one of those. There's another hold on the edge that is not called. And just buying enough space, Halliday. No, but this looks like more than just an ankle that he looked to be hobbling on earlier.
But then there's also the block by Caldwell.
The previous play is under review.
So we're going to look at the previous play to see if he did in fact make the catch. But Caldwell came up with a big block with Lucas King going airborne to try to get to Connor Halliday.
Look at this. This is how tough Connor Halliday is. Nobody even bothers going over and checking. It's not an option for him to come out of the game. It looked like he could barely walk. The only one to go talk to him is Leach. Enjoyed watching both these quarterbacks compete here today, and two guys that we hit on off the top. Two guys that you know, knocked out of the game by Stanford was Halliday. And you know, Goff, of course, with his struggles with the turnovers, he's been fantastic in rebounding as well.
Let's see if Galvin had control of the ball. Looked to me like he had control if that foot was down there.
Even though it was oddly held, the angle, it looked like he did secure it. That ball wasn't moving. And remember, it's called a catch on the field.
The band here is playing a theme song from Jeopardy.
After review, ruling on the field stands. Completed pass, first down.
You know, it's surprising, you talk about bands around here. Stanford's the one with the goofy band. They do all the skits and everything. Driving around Berkeley, you'd think it'd be the other way around. This is, you know, a traditional band here. Maybe one of the only things that is traditional here on campus, right?
The stadium, the basketball arena.
Beautiful.
First and 10, Halliday. Short pass to Gabe Marks. And Marks is out at the 40 by Michael Lowe. An 8-yard completion.
That's a nice first down play. Guys showing you how much they respect the sophomore Marks. He just puts his foot in the ground, sticks it, comes right back, and on first down you get 8. It's an offense that's clicking right now, and a quarterback and some receivers that are on the same page.
Second and 2, Cal showing they're going to come with the pressure. Lofted pass, complete to Maley, and Maley had his foot grabbed and would not let go.
Well, and that's all I want, Justin. That's Cedric Dozier. It not quite textbook, coming under control and overrunning a little bit, but holding on for dear life, just wrapping up, giving your buddies a chance to come help you out. I can live with that all day long in this day and age, especially in football.
Most likely the final play of this quarter. Halliday's pass on the slant, completed again to Christoph Williams. And Williams very close to that first down. This third quarter is over. Both teams are over 500 yards in the game. It is 35-22, Washington State
over Cal.
And it is a first down coming up for the Cougars. Thirteen-point lead for Washington State as we start the fourth quarter. We sit at the top of this broadcast, 1,200 total yards between these teams. Maybe you should have taken the over.
Getting close.
Halliday to the end zone. Oh, nice play. Adrian Lee broke it up. Gabe Marks, the intended receiver.
Third stringer, Adrian Lee, by the way. Fantastic job. Stride for stride. Snap that head around. Make sure you don't get the separation that we just talked about on the last drive for Cal. And, oh, by the way, starting on the other side, or playing on the other side right now, is Dozier, another third-string corner who made a good tackle in the third quarter towards the end.
On second and 10, Halliday over the middle. That one is incomplete. River Craycraft and Vince Maley were there.
And there's Dozier, And enough time, that one is on Connor Halliday. A couple steps, the bigger body Maley walks in. If he just puts it right underneath him, well, goodness, maybe he was going Craig Kraft underneath, but deep on the next level was Maley, who had an easy touchdown if he gets it back there.
Third and 10.
They need the pressure.
Halliday, pass is incomplete. Was trying to hit Christoph Williams. Adrian Lee there on the coverage again. All right, so here comes Andrew Ferney out for a field goal attempt. He missed from 39 earlier. It'll be a 44-yard attempt this time.
I think they kind of like Ferney up in Pullman. The game tire and the Apple Cup with 2 minutes remaining, and then the game winner against Washington in overtime last year.
From 44 this time, and this time it is good. 3 points on the board for the Cougars. Leading by 16. Nearly a catch by River Craycraft. It was not, so instead the field goal by Ferney. 38-22, Washington State. You cannot have a much prettier day here in Northern California looking across the bay. It is a 38-22 ball game as Washington State leads Cal. 14:39 to go in the fourth quarter. Look at the Golden Gate Bridge. That is just spectacular.
Here's Alcatraz then, right? Right there below it. Wow. And that you can see from the backside of the press box here at Memorial Stadium.
Bigelow from 1 yard deep in the end zone. Bigelow trying to get to the outside. And Bigelow is out of bounds at the 22 by Buchanan. Let's check back in with Patrick O'Neill for a game break.
Yeah, quickly, the shocker of the day has been in Knoxville, Tennessee. Volunteers running back Rayshon Neal, 7 yard touchdown, gives the Vols the 31-24 lead over the Georgia Bulldogs. But Georgia has first and a goal. 21 seconds left in the fourth quarter. So, guys, hey, we'll keep you updated on that one, Justin and James.
And I'll let you in on a bit of a secret, Patrick. We actually just turned that game on in our booth, so we've got it going on as we're watching this game. It's first and 10 here for Cal. Goff gets it as he releases. Was looking for Richard Rodgers. Incomplete, the pressure applied by Xavier Cooper. We're just trying to multitask, right, Bates?
Well, we and this Cal offensive line better keep their eyes on Cooper. We've seen Inauta and, of course, Pole. Those three starters on the defensive line have really been fantastic.
Jared Goff, this time he does find Richard Rodgers. And Rodgers, with that spot, has enough for the first down.
He's got the Rodgers the second. He really could be Rich Rod the second, if you think about it, too. His dad played at Cal, now a special teams coach for the Carolina Panthers in the NFL.
On first down, it's a handoff to Coppridge. Coppridge got hit right away by Xavier Cooper.
You know, it was funny. We had a nice sit-down with Richard yesterday. What a nice young man, the junior receiver. And talked about all these passing camps, these elite camps, 7-on-7s that go on. And that's why you see so many young quarterbacks ready to play and receivers with such great hands. He said, I've just been around my dad's camps and practices, just throw a lot and catch a lot of footballs. That's why I've got good hands.
Goff, a high throw. That's incomplete. Was looking for Darius Powell.
We've had some offenses that ending that first half, Justin, it certainly looked like we were going to be in for a tennis match, almost bouncing back and forth, but it's settled down a little bit, and thanks in large part to some good defensive play on that defensive line right now for the Cougs.
Third and 10. Goff dancing around, flags come flying out. The pass is incomplete for Steven Anderson.
Good job by Palacio to make sure they saw it. There have been a lot of holds that have been allowed.
Offense, number 64. Penalty is declined. Fourth down.
That have been allowed to go throughout the day. Palacio flailing those arms, making sure everybody in the house saw it.
And while you were looking at that, Georgia just scored a touchdown. Now an extra point to try to tie it.
See, and that's, I'm telling you, Justin, that big game, yeah, but big month, none bigger than the Bulldogs past month. Some great wins for Murray and company. You got to think there's going to be a letdown.
Great punt, Leon Brooks on the return, and Brooks gets spun around at the 25-yard line. A 48-yard punt, 6-yard return. Connor Halliday has 478 yards passing today, looking for 500. These two teams. You know, Connor Halliday, 478, Jared Goff, 449. But the story really of this game goes back to that first quarter with Cal losing two fumbles around the 5-yard line, one at the goal line.
And one on the opening drive when they needed to open this game with something good after struggling up last week against Oregon. Both these teams, remember, 55-17 was the final for the Oregon and Cal game, and or 55-16 rather, 55-17 was the Stanford Washington State game. So both these teams need a win in a big way. We got a lot of ball left to play, a lot of points and yards I'm sure to be put up too.
Second down and 10. Halliday, that quick slant complete to Bobby Ratliff, and Ratliff up to the 29-yard line. Gets 4 yards, sets up third down and 6.
Halliday going right where he felt that pressure come from. They brought Lucas King there on the blitz and just chip away at it. Now a third down in medium, and a big one as they start to make some noise here in Memorial Stadium. Again, the pressure has made it tougher on third downs when they brought a little bit, when they brought a blitz of some sort.
Third and 6. It is incomplete. Was looking for Ratliff. So a 3-and-out forced here by the Cal defense. That's a great job by Cal's defense to get their offense back on the field. And you can see Halliday still kind of limping off the field, playing through all the pain.
Well, and look back last week. You talk about last week, those Oregon Ducks. How different are these two quarterbacks? Halliday, as it is, isn't known as a runner. Marcus Mariota can hurt you as much as anybody in the nation with his feet. Totally changes the way you approach a football game defensively.
Chris Harper backed up the 27. Harper gets it back up the 39-yard line. And that's where Cal will take over, but a flag on the play. It was a 43-yard punt, 11-yard return. Waiting to find out the call here from Jack Wood.
Holding number 40 of the kicking team. Penalty will be enforced from the end of the play, 10 yards, first down.
So now even better field position here for Cal to start their drive trailing by 16. Looking at the standings, these two teams in the Pac-12 North. And you got to think that Pac-12 North will come down to Stanford against Oregon, although don't sleep on Washington. And in the South, UCLA got a big road win on Thursday night at Utah.
How about that Washington and Stanford game today? Be a fun one, too. Oh, goodness. See, and this is going to come back and bite this team. You're playing with fire when you just lob it up there and hope for something good to happen. Early in the first half, there was a ball that was just lofted up there, but there have been about 4 or 5 times that the freshmen just hoping something can happen. And fortunately, each time it's hit the turf.
The pressure was applied by Xavier Cooper, second down and 10. Jared Goff completes the pass to Harper, and Harper got tripped up. A pickup of 5. Third and 5 coming up. It was Mitchell Peterson with a tackle.
The pressure is starting to come up the gut, and Goff's forced to throw these balls off his heels.
A high snap, and he's able to get it and then complete the pass to Triggs for the first down.
Brady, our guy Brzezinski, Mark Brzezinski, who stepped in to start at center, has done a pretty good job, but now some of those guys on the inside are starting to put some pressure, and there was a high snap. They're starting to get to him a little bit here.
First and 10. Goff taking the shot, and that is incomplete to Trex. Daquan Brown there on the coverage.
Careful with those hands there, Daquan. Choosing to use that and put that wing out there. You're in perfect position. Saw a little bit too much of it early. Some guys that have settled down a little bit and gotten a little less feely, so we haven't seen as many flags, but got to keep them there inside your body and just snap that head around. Play good ball.
Second down and 10. Another high snap. Handoff. This time is to Brendan Bigelow, and Bigelow got wrapped up. Back of the line of scrimmage by Darryl Paolo. And with 11:23 to go, still plenty of time on the clock here for Cal. Isn't that right, Brady?
There's tons of time left on the clock, and that's because Washington State really doesn't like to run the football. And I'll tell you what, guys, when you're up 16 points in the fourth quarter, there's not a better time to start eating the clock than using your running game, but Washington State just doesn't happen.
Third and 9. Pass is incomplete. The fans were looking for a flag. Drake Whitehurst, the intended receiver, Daquan Brown on the coverage. And now you're at decision time here. You gotta go for it. Fourth and 9 from the 37-yard line.
11 minutes, you don't have to go for it. Your defense has been playing a little bit better. You can pin them down there and give them even more. There's plenty of time. Two scores and two extra point conversions, but let's see.
Empty backfield. Goff over the middle, overthrows Harper. Pressure coming again by Xavier Cooper and Nauta. So Cal's defense did the job. Now Washington State's defense does the job. On fourth and 9, Goff staying in there. He takes a hit. His team trails by 16.
You're watching a Fox Sports presentation. We'll have more right after this.
When it's a beautiful day here in Berkeley, California, and you're a student at Berkeley, you don't always go to a football game. Maybe you'll play some music in the park or do some reading and studying.
Yeah, but I'll bet you they're out there reading about football, and he's probably...
I'll bet you they're not.
Singing the Lonesome Kicker or something, Sandler song. Yeah, you're right. You win. How about that? 85 and 85. And they come from the same tree, you were saying? These two head coaches, Sonny Dykes and Mike Leach.
Difference in this game right now, 4 turnovers for Cal, 1 for Washington State.
That's the last thing Sonny Dykes said to us. He said culture a lot, but he said taking care of the football is the difference.
Meeting is hand off to Caldwell. And Caldwell up to the 15-yard line, make it a 16-yard line, gets the first down. Cameron Walker with a tackle. Just about 5.5 left in this one. James, you mentioned this before and we were talking about it, but the importance of this game, coming off losses, both these teams. Last week, a loss by Washington State to Stanford, and Cal lost to Oregon. If you look at the schedule before the year, you look at this game, and both teams, I think, would say, that's a game that we could and probably should win. And as you're trying to get bowl eligible at the end of the year, this is one of those games that you circle. And right now, 41-22, it could be a big win here for the Cougars.
Well, and don't the guys from Washington State know it? No postseason play since 2003. And here, let's take a look at it. They got to go against Oregon State, and then they got to go to Eugene and play Oregon. But there aren't any layups the rest of the way. You have to fight and scrap to get all you can. But this is win number 4 at the end of the day for Mike Leach, who took Texas Tech in all 10 seasons to a bowl game.
Last year they went 3-9, so with a win here today, they would already surpass their win total from last year. Halliday swings it out. Caldwell with the catch. He gets tackled by Lucas King.
maybe not quite New Mexico State grounds, but well, 9 seasons is a long time with all the bowl games that are in college football right now. You know, it's like some of those spring practices, the awards that coaches hand out at the end of them. You might want to check, see if you're wanted. If you don't get an award at spring practice or these bowl games, you...
I think there are 35 or 36 bowl games.
Is when does the one in the Bahamas start up? Is that this year? Can we fight to get on that one?
35, and the pass is incomplete.
You know, I think that Bill and Ed, our stats guy and spotter, they deserve that. We deserve to go call that bowl in the Bahamas. They've worked hard this year. Well, there's, you know what, Washington State fans, you got a tough quarterback right there, a Washington kid who has hobbled throughout the day. And, you know, the scary thing is, though, as you look at how tough that schedule gets, you know, an ankle, it's not going to get any better without plenty of rest, so it may be a whole lot more of that. But fortunately, that's not something that your quarterback hangs his hat on, is being able to run. But still, the ability to buy time is huge for a quarterback.
Fernie from 28 makes it. And so he is 3-for-4 on the day for field goals. And now it's 44-22. We talked about the upcoming schedule for Washington State. How about what's coming up for Cal? And it is not pretty, really. At UCLA, at Washington, they end at Stanford. And oh, by the way, they've already played number 22 Northwestern, number 4 Ohio State, and at number 2 Oregon.
Well, it's, you know, and it says a lot about the Pac-12. And when you get guys, you look at the head coaches top to bottom in this league. And here's, you know, a new kid on the block, Sonny Dykes. Oh, yeah, by the way, Pac-12. There's a guy now in Berkeley whose team down in Ruston, Louisiana last year led the nation in total offense, could have, should have beaten Johnny Manziel and Texas A&M in their great run. But, you know, one thing, though. They did it with a great running back and a freshman running back that we've seen a lot of the last couple weeks here on Fox Sports 1 in Kenneth Dixon. And that's one thing they've got to develop here in Berkeley is a running game, because Dykes wants to do just that to set everything up.
Treggs on the return. It's tackled at the 19-yard line. You know, it's funny talking with Sonny Dykes about coming here to Cal. And he said, I don't think you can have two places that are more different than Ruston, Louisiana and Berkeley, California. And I think he might be right.
Well, you know, and I'm sure Ruston is a lot like Lubbock, Texas, where he spent a lot of time coming up. His dad was a great coach there.
Zach Klein now in at quarterback. Replacing Goff, and his first pass is completed to Bryce Treggs. Zach Klein was an Under Armour All-American a couple years ago. A redshirt freshman.
And it was Austin Hinder was part of that battle for the starting job in camp along with Klein. Jared Goff.
Completes his second pass to James Grissom. 7-yard completion.
Well, Zach, also from this area, from the East Bay, and you know what? How about the job that Zach Klein did making his Oregon debut, going 18 of 37 against Oregon on the road, as poor conditions as you could ever imagine. And hey, by the way, Jared Goff can't hold on to the football tonight. Get out there and do all you can. You know, it wasn't a bad shot for a guy who didn't realize he'd play any football that night.
Another handoff to Michael Bartolo. Jared Goff, what did he do here in this game today? 3 of the top 4 single game passing yard marks in Cal history. And remember, there was a guy who played here. I think Brady knows him pretty well. Aaron Rodgers. Klein's pass is tipped and nearly intercepted by DeMonte Horton.
Now, didn't Brady get some tips on where to go and what to do from Aaron Rodgers via the text message today?
Yeah, I think the biggest advice that he gave me being here in Berkeley is to stay away from the hemp necklaces and the hemp brownies. I don't know what that means, but I said, okay, thank you.
I don't think we have to worry about Papinga eating any funny brownies around here.
Intercepts it. Daquan Brown intercepts Zach Klein. With 2:15 left on the clock.
Well, Daquan getting a nice pick. We weren't sure they'd have him. Last week he left the game injured and showing a little bit of scoot afterwards as well. I mean, why not? A freshman, pretty excited. Get a big pick here. Remember, he started that USC game. That was a nice, you know, we talk about these four wins, how they've surpassed last season. And it was a time when USC was 25th in the nation. He did an outstanding job. How about the task he drew of defending Lee, Marquise Lee?
A tackle in the backfield by Hardy Nickerson. A loss of four, but how about this for Cal? Five turnovers and 11 penalties. For the second straight week. You're not going to win the games with that combination.
No, and you know, to add to that, the missed tackles to give up the big plays. It's, you know, you circle one of those stat categories and say, we can't have this. We can't have the turnovers. If you have the turnovers alone, even if you don't have many penalties, you don't have many missed tackles, it's going to be tough to win a football game, let alone when you got all three.
Washington State will take a knee here. Our Right Stuff player of the game presented by Academy Sports and Outdoors is Connor Halliday, playing injured, setting a single game record for 67 attempts at Washington State, 521 yards, three touchdowns and one interception.
37 now in his career, the Spokane kid. You see, that's one thing they're not used to. You talk about not used to winning. Not sure what that signal is. Oh yeah, it's a victory formation. The birds coming in. Can't believe we went this whole broadcast and I didn't mention yet Missy Franklin. Oh, Missy Franklin swam yesterday for Cal. There you go. Got to mention the swimmers whenever we can. Four-time gold medalist.
I was gonna say, what's wrong with you?
Yeah, a dual meet yesterday. How about this, what she's done for swimming? And Mike Leach is a swimmer too. They said that he's been over there at Washington State. Coach over there, Tom Jagger, one of the best swimmers in the world at one time. Now the coach at Washington State, they had a dual meet and there were four writers and five photographers at a swim meet.
Their first charge time out of the half. This will be a 30-second timeout.
They were hoping to make this a four-hour game, right? Yeah, so with that timeout, we might just get there. With 10 seconds left, you know who hasn't left? The fans on Tightwad Hill, because you know why they haven't left? They didn't pay for the tickets. By the way, we said 1,200 total yards. We were wrong. 11:55 at this point.
You were way off.
Swami wow. Samsonite. I was way off.
Oh, what a treat. This my first trip to come call a football game here in my Tightwad Hill and taking me down to Cream yesterday, get some of those ice cream sandwiches. This has been nice. I know the hometown guys didn't have as much fun, but guys like Big Nauta, wow, you're gonna see more of him in the Pac-12 this year and on Sundays. You can mark that down.
Bowling with the punts. And this one takes a bounce for Washington State. We'll be down. Let's see if they ran the clock out.